Hello everyone, I'm going to guide you through Domo. I will show you some of its features and capabilities. First, let me show you quickly the navigation bar it has. It has here like the dashboard, which is the landing page generally when you enter into your Domo account, and it's where all dashboards and the main visualizations are. Then the alerts, it's basically to configure and manage your notifications, for example, when new data is added or some dashboards has been changed. The bus section, which is basically an internal chat with other users of your organization account. The App Store, which is basically like a marketplace from Azure or similar from other clouds. The data one is one of the most important ones. It's where you can manage all the data sets, which data set is basically how Domo calls to the files or data that have been uploaded into Domo. And it's where we are currently at now. And then there's the more button, where are obviously more things like the admin, which is like the place where you can manage the users, the groups, the roles and permissions in general, the governance. The analyzer one is where you can edit and create the individual reports or cards, how are called here in Domo, or the data science section. So I wanted to mention that as we are in the data one, in the data section, there are two new navigation panels. The top one, which has all these things, and the left one has these ones. There are many things to cover, but we will do it along of this presentation. So first, let me explain the data warehouse, which is currently the current one we are at. So as we can see here, there's like a spinning circle that basically represents the Domo data warehouse. Here are these green cylinders that are like all the different data sources we have connected to Domo. So if we hover over them, we can see some, like it is like, for example, a dataset view. Here is an Amazon S3. Here is like Azure Synapse SQL. So basically all the different data sources. And if we hover into all of them, specifically we can see like the number of data sets that come from this connector. And in this case, for example, in S3, 22 data sets can be, for example, 22 files or 22 folders that contain many files. It depends generally in the connector that you use to ingest the data. You can also see the total rows that has been imported and also the number of cards, which are the individual reports related to these data sets. So, well, the height of the cylinders are basically the amount of data that you can see at first glance. Okay, so beside the internal data that is uploaded into Domo, there's also the federated agent capability. For example, we have here defined an Azure Synapse federated agent, where basically we have different data sets, one for different tables. For example, this one for the customer, this is for supplier, region, per support. So basically all the different tables in this Azure. So this is like the main view when you are using only Domo as your data warehouse, but Domo also enables the possibility to add like another data warehouse, just in case, for example, if a client has, I don't know, Snowflake as its main data warehouse, you can add it here and use Domo, for example, as an integrated tool to do, for example, the ETL part rather than the entire storage, and use Snowflake obviously as the storage one. So if we want to add all of them, we can click here, and here we see the different adapters that Domo provides, and in this case we could select the Domo one and fill all the account data that we should configure to connect to Snowflake. So basically, this account thing is like an utility where you place all these credentials and configuration things, and all of them are stored here in this accounts page. In this case, we have here some for Athena and a couple of them for S3. So we've seen that we can import data into it, into Domo. But to do this, we need to use the connectors. Okay, so basically the connectors, as we can see here, are the different engines that we use to import the data. So in this case, for example, if we wanted to import data from S3, we would come here, write S3, and we could use any of these connectors. So as we can see, we have like different connectors for the same thing, but all of them have their specific configuration. Also, there are some connectors that allow to write back data from Domo to S3, for example, in this case. But here, as you see, it's in red and unlocked. It's basically because you have to ask permission to Domo to enable it. Here, let me show here. So here is this connectors one, and here there's the file and database button, but they don't have much sense because it's basically coming here, and it's this one is the database and this one is the file, so it's repeated, and you can obviously upload files directly from your local PC. And there's also the federated section to configure the federated agents. So it's basically again creating a new account, configuring it, and you would be able to connect to data. And lastly, they have also this API, which is basically a client command line tool to which is a jar file to interact with Domo from outside Domo, you know, for creating scripts and etc. So jumping into the data per se, we will go here, okay, in the datasets section. So here we are in the, sorry, let me see. Okay, so here we are at the page where all the datasets are listed. Here we have, for example, 84 datasets in our account. So here we can see, like for each dataset, we can see like the name we have provided, the type of dataset, because there are different types. For example, these are the data flows, which are basically the ETL name of the of Domo. But we have, like, I don't know, Domo web form, dataset view, CSV. So we have all different types. We can see also the name of the dataset, the who owned it, which is basically who created it, the number of rows that has been imported from it, the number of cards or individual reports that are linked to this dataset. You can also add tags for filtering and basically governance. And you can see here the last run, and it's basically when it was last run, the connector to ingest the data. So let me jump into one of them. Okay, the S3 line. Yeah. So this is one of the ones that we used. Okay. So basically, this is the main page to see like the individual data sets. So basically, data sets are like a wrapper that contains metadata and general information about the data per se. No? We can see here like the number of columns that has been imported, the number of rows. And here we have like a general overview where we can see, for example, this really interesting section where we can see all the data sets that are impacted from this one. So for example, if we want to remove this data set, we should be careful because 9 ETL processes depend on this data, another 22 data sets depend on this also. Let me show it, for example, here in this top side, here we have the data where we can preview all the data of the dataset. Here is the card section. Here we don't have any card created for this one, but I will show you later. Then there's the settings of the connectors, And this is the lineage, which is basically the impacts we've seen before in the overview. And here we can see in a nice and smooth way how this dataset is directly impacting to this one, this, and these three ones. But these ones are impacted by all of these ones. So the lineage is really simple to see and really easy to manage. Then also, there's also the history section that is specific for the data sets that are directly connected to external data. In this case, this is one case because it's connected to S3, but another data set that is, for example, the output of an ETL, it would have this history. So here basically it's like a list of the history events where the data has been imported. The PDP is basically the policies, names and access for permissions, and the areas where you can configure some notifications, for example, here, like when notify me when any row is added or changed or deleted. Well, there's also the machine learning part, but we don't have it enabled, and we didn't ask permission for it because we didn't have time to cover all of the aspects of Domo. So now I'm going to show you here again the overview. Here is like tidy up this dataset. It's basically creating a ETL. This symbol is the data flow. It's creating an ETL process to clean the data, for example. So if we click here, automatically it's put this box, which is our dataset, and it's basically a drag and drop boxes ETL tool where we can add, for example, here an output dataset, and here we are all the boxes with all the transformation, no? String operations, replace text, date operations, alter column, select. So there are a lot of possible transformations. So here, for example, we can add the alter columns, link our dataset to these alter columns. We can select the column we want, we can rename it to I don't know, to whatever name. We can select also if we want to cast the data to another one, another type, or we can drop columns with a single click. And oh, sorry, and then we can join it to the next box to save this data set. Okay, so basically we can run a preview, save it, or save it and run. Okay, I'll do it, but okay, so basically we see here like it's running, and whenever it finishes, we will see all the data in the dataset page. So this ETL page or tool is one of the three that Domo offers. So if we go back to here we are in the data flows page, not in the data sets, because all the data flows are also stored here. So here are the three different ETL tools. The first one that I show is this one, but they also have, like, for example, the blend, which is a really simple one where we can select data, data set, sorry, and join with other ones, for example, with region. Okay, choose. And here we can select if joining by rows, which is basically concatenating the data sets. This is really useful if the data is the same, but we have it split it in different data sets. We can join all together in one. Or basically doing a join by columns where we can select, I don't know, from nation the region key, and from region the region key in a inner join, whatever. And we can click the preview, and the output data set would be this one. Okay, I'm not going to run this. And the last ETL process is the SQL. They offer like three SQL expressions where you can code. It's basically the MySQL, the Redshift, and the Adrenaline. Adrenaline is the one that they provide, a custom one from Domo. So basically, the page we see is here we can write a name for the data flow. Here we can select the data set. In this case, we can select again the region, and at the output data set is where we can store the output of our SQL. So for example, here we could do a select everything from S3 region where name, here it's name, whatever, no, it's like, for example, no? And we could run a preview of the data, of the query, sorry, and then we could apply it and save it and run it. So as we can see, all the ETLs end up in a dataset in Domo. So now let's jump into the visualization part. Okay, let me go back. So let's go back to the datasets. I will show you one that is called GJ, this one, okay, that we have 18 cards. So we click on here, and this is the overview. So we click again into the cards page, and here we can see and preview all the cards or individual reports related to this data set. No? Here we can see that we can create like buttons to filter, tables, bar charts, pie charts, a lot of ones. We can also put text with calculations here, which is, for example, the total from the total price from the orders table, links, also images. So this is like to preview them. If we want to edit any of them, we can simply, I know this one, we can click them. This is like a more in detail preview, but if we want to edit the card, we should go to the analyzer page here. So we can see here on the right, there are all the different chart types where we basically can click and everything is changed automatically. It's really simple to use. There are here the dimensions, the measures, where we can drag and drop everything. Then there's the biz modes and segments, which are basically like operations that you can store and then reuse in other cards. So there are a lot of things here. You can preview the data that you are using for this card. You can see the lineage always. This is the data we are using, so you can see where it comes from. Then obviously you can apply filters. Well, other thing, colors, where you can define themes and specific colors for things. For example, we could specify that Mondays are always red, and we can apply this to each individual card or in general to all the cards that we do. And okay, so this is basically to edit a single card, and if we want to do a dashboard, okay, it's good. Let's go here. And okay, we are here in the retail view new. It's basically a dashboard where we can gather together different cards from different data sets. So in this case, we've done a really dummy one, okay? It basically has some filters here and some visualizations where you can obviously interact with them. And yeah, basically you can click on any filter, it's applying everything. Here you can see filtering, and everything is filtered quite quick. And all these filters are stored here. You can save them and they will be like here. So basically you can go directly to some predefined filters that you've done, or furthermore you can, like for example, assign some filters to some groups or some users, so they would only see the filtered data. Furthermore, if we want to edit this dashboard, we should go here to this branch, and edit the dashboard, and basically we enter in the like the editor mode, where here on the right we have, for example, this thing, which are the layouts. We can drag and drop them as always in Domo. We can select here like the number of cards we want to place. For example, we can select, I don't know, 4 cards, and this template of layout is placed here. So basically you can go to existing cards and select any one that you want, and you can always edit the sizes, you can remove ones if you don't like them. So it's really simple to use and really intuitive. Yeah, basically that's the visualization part in Domo. And lastly, let me show you. Lastly, I'm going to show you a bit of the admin part, which is basically the governance. So it's here. Basically, here you can control the users, add all the users. You can create groups to place different users in it. You can create custom roles. You can grant individual permissions to the roles or to the users. You can predefine that some data of the user accounts and allow to only administration to edit it. For example, you can put that the department section is done, well, it's written by the administrator, and you can divide logically your users. There's also the activity log, where you can see all the last, well, all the last, no, all the activities that have been done in the account. So basically that's Domo. So as we have seen so far, Domo can cover all the steps needed in a BI project, leveraging all the tools and features that this all-in-one SaaS platform offers. We have covered many aspects of Domo, such as its powerful governance, its simple ETL tools, and the visualization elements like cards and dashboards that leverage the data analysis without the need of any piece of code. And even though we have seen only a peek of its capabilities and features, we can conclude that Domo is a potential great solution to deliver modern BI to organizations to make data-driven decisions.